Hey, oh, man, my tripod. Okay, sorry I didn't notice earlier that my video didn't turn out so good about the catalogs that I was trying to share with you. So, let's start with the non-GMO catalogs. I get Baker Creek Heirloom Seeds catalog. I get it each year, and these are all non-GMO, and it's a nice big catalog. And it's all non-GMO stuff in here, and it gives you lots of options. I can't remember what the shipping was like. Let's look at it. And I can also put links underneath. I'll make sure this video is better. Shipping is only $3.50 on this. You're ordering seeds, so shipping is pretty cheap on it. There's some books in here also. Some twine and garden planner, copper plant markers. I think I'm gonna make some plant markers this year. But this one has lots of vegetables in it. And it does have some herbs and some flowers, medicinal herbs and stuff. So I've ordered a lot through here. And then let's see, that one is out of, is it out of California? I forget where it's out of. Oh, there we go. Missouri. Alright, then there's Seed Savers Exchange. And this is catalog of heirloom, untreated, non-hybrid, non-GMO seeds. And trying to see where this one is from. So let's go to the order form. And they have the same kind of seed collection in here, but they have more books in here. Oh, and then they have seed saver supplies like the envelopes and such. Those are really handy if you like sharing your seeds with people like I do. Oh, there we go. Let's see what their shipping is here. Oh no, this is the exchange planning and seed saving guide, not their order form. Here's their order form. Where does it say? Shipping. $10 or less is $3. $10 up to $20 is $4. $20 up to $30 is $6. It just goes up like that. You can become a member. I haven't become a member of this. Nope. I'm not even sure if I have ordered from these guys or not, but they're non-GMO too. And they're on Facebook, and the other ones are on Facebook, and this one's on YouTube also. I can put links, like I said, underneath this video if this video turns out decent. Yeah, so the shipping is more on that catalog. And this catalog, the shipping's less, and it's non-GMO. And look how big the catalog is. And both are free catalogs. And then there's this one from you from Utah, and it's Maple Leaf Company Seed Catalog. This is more of a agricultural and erosion control and farming and stuff like that. Yeah, it's Ephraim, Utah. This catalog is late. Let's see. The tabs at the right will guide you to plant types separated into three major groups: grasses, forbs, and shrubs. The orange section contains Haystack Mountain brand grain, commodities, forage, grasses, and custom mixes. So, this is a really handy one. And at first I thought, wow, their shipping is expensive, but I didn't realize that when you ordered, it was like a pound that you were ordering of seed. It's not just like a little seed pouch. Seed for sage grouse habitat. Conservation reserve programs, mining, exploration, and reclamation. And all sorts of stuff like that. Grass likes. It has places here to even write notes in there. Flowers, forbs, and legumes. Now, I haven't ordered, like I said, because it's like the shipping was expensive. Like, they have Indian paintbrush, which I would love to get to grow. And so that's a pound of seed. I think you have to go online to get the prices for these. I'm just checking. This is a really cool catalog though, and very educational. Yeah, I think you gotta go online. I had made a list and stuff, and then I seen the shipping, but I didn't realize those were a pound of seed. Yeah, I'm not seeing any prices in the catalog, so you gotta go online. But with that catalog came Haystack Mountain cover crops. And native shrubs, grasses, forbs, custom collections, specialty mixes. And then Prospector 3 grain forage mixture, beardless forage seed. Sow diversity, reap prosperity. So, I mean, we're talking about like farming grade stuff here. But I'll put the links to all of, I forgot. We have the English roses from David Austin. These are some of my favorite. The only problem with this, I mean, this catalog is beautiful and everything, but it doesn't have the dates of each plant. And I like to have the dates, but the good thing with this is it gives a good description, gives beautiful pictures, and it gives you the scents. It describes the scents really nicely, and I like that. And this is just a beautiful catalog. But like I said, I really wish that it would give you the this is the English rose, so they're not going into the antique part of it, which is the dates and everything, which is, that's really interesting in itself, to know the date of your rose bush. Yeah, because a lot of these roses, they're antiques. These English ones, a lot of them that have the strong smells and stuff. And it would be nice if they just would put the years on. I mean, I'm seeing some years here, but I don't know. I'm going to have to see if I can come up with a catalog for antiques with the years for you guys so you can see what I mean. Because, I mean, these here are like 1996 and stuff that developed by David Austin. But I'm talking about some of the original plants, which are the strong damask and everything. Yeah. This catalog is just so beautiful, though. And it is educational, like just like I said, it would be nice if it had the years and had some more of the antiques with the years. Alright, I'm tired. Hopefully this video turns out better than that last one. So I'll check it before I upload it. Okay, hugs and love. Sorry that you couldn't see on that last one. Bye.